Once, when she was a little creature of 3 or 4 years, she suddenly brought her tiny foot down upon the floor in an apparent outbreak of indignation, then fetched it a backward wipe, and stooped down to examine the result. Her mother said, "Why, what is it, child? What has stirred you so?" "Mama, the big ant was trying to kill the little one."
"And so you protected the little one?"
"Yes, Mama, because he had no friend, and I wouldn't let the big one kill him."
"But you have killed them both."
Cathy was distressed, and her lip trembled. She picked up the remains and laid them upon her palm, and said, "Poor little auntie, I'm so sorry, and I didn't mean to kill you, but there wasn't any other way to save you, it was such a hurry."
"She is a dear and sweet little lady, and when she goes it will give me a sore heart. But she will be happy with you, and if your heart is old and tired, give it into her keeping. She will make it young again, she will refresh it, she will make it sing. Be good to her for all our sakes. My exile will soon be over now. As soon as I am a little stronger, I shall see my Spain again, and that will make me young again. Mercedes."
End of chapter 2. A Horse's Tale by Mark Twain. Chapter 3. General Allison to His Mother.
"I am glad to know that you are all well in San Bernardino. That grandchild of yours has been here, well, I do not quite know how many days it is. Nobody can keep account of days or anything else where she is. Mother, she did what the Indians were never able to do. She took the fort, took it the first day, took me too, took the colonels, the captains, the women, the children, and the dumb brutes, took Buffalo Bill and all his scouts, took the garrison to the last man, and in 48 hours the Indian encampment was hers, illustrious old Thunderbird and all. Do I seem to have lost my solemnity, my gravity, my poise, my dignity? You would lose your own in my circumstances. Mother, you never saw such a winning little devil. She is all energy and spirit and sunshine and interest in everybody and everything, and pours out her prodigal love upon every creature that will take it, high or low, Christian or pagan, feathered or furred, and none has declined it to date, and none ever will, I think. But she has a temper, and sometimes it catches fire and flames up, and is likely to burn whatever is near it. But it is soon over.